Do you need your forms to do more inside of SmartSuite? Listen, SmartSuite is not predominantly a form tool. Although they have basic form functionality, sometimes you need more. Well, I am happy to announce that Fillout has now completed their integration and we can do way more with Fillout, which is a native form software. So in this video, I'm gonna be breaking down some of the new amazing things that you can do with a fill-out form that was not previously available with the native forms inside of SmartSuite. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. At the forefront of these no-code tools is SmartSuite, and thankfully now Fillout as well. We are very excited about the new integration between Fillout and SmartSuite because, as I mentioned earlier, it's going to allow us to do even more inside of our forms with SmartSuite by using this native integration. But before we get into it, I first want to invite you to join me for my automation training. Automation is one of those components of no code that will allow you to just reclaim so much of your time when you start automating those repetitive tasks. If you are new to no code in general, or if you just want a good refresher, check out my free training at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. That is going to allow you to get instant access once you sign up to a presentation where I've put together the key fundamentals of automation for you in no code. Go ahead and grab that. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. If you have your own SmartSuite account, of course, pop that open and follow along with me. And if you don't, you can grab the link below and get signed up with SmartSuite for free today on a free trial. Let's go ahead and hop on in and talk about what we are doing with this particular example. So, number one, we need a way to capture people's information. And of course, a form is a great way to do that. We are putting ownership of the information on behalf of or onto the other person who we're requesting information from. In our example, I have a text field here called first name, and I'm wanting to get the first name. I've got a text field for last name. I have a phone number field, and I've got an email field type. Now, there are plenty of other types of fields that we can ask for, but these are the ones we're going to be using in our particular example. Now, let's go ahead and imagine our first scenario, which is just to create a form. We can do this inside of SmartSuite natively. In order to do that, we would just go over here to our views. We can drop down to create a new view, and we can see down here at the bottom that we can add a new form. By doing that, we can just automatically create that form, no problem there. However, that's kind of where these forms stop. If I want to do anything more advanced with the form, like, for example, allow people to update their information that they've already given me, or maybe any other number of complex workloads where I have a long chain of events that all triggers off of this one form, well, it's not possible. The form inside of SmartSuite is pretty simple. It just says, hey, when somebody submits this form, it's going to create a single record inside of whatever application that form lives in. So here I am in my contact form data. It'll create one record here and one record only. It does not update records. It does not create multiple records. It only does that. But this is why we need third-party form software. So let's go ahead and flip into Fillout, and I'll show you how easy it is to get set up. Now, for our first example, we're just going to build the same form that we would have inside of SmartSuite. A simple form to capture that basic contact information: name, first and last, email, and phone number. Well, inside of Fillout, we are going to start in the upper right corner here and just say new form. If you have your own Fillout, of course, open it up and follow along with me here. And if you don't, be sure to sign up with our link below as well. All right, so inside of here, new form. You'll notice that we can just create a blank form. We can get started with the template. But what I want here is to connect to existing tools that I already have. Now, by default, or up at the top, I'm going to see Airtable, Notion, and Google Sheets. But now we can click on another integration. And there it is. We see our friend SmartSuite right here. And the nice part about this is we don't have to build any kind of advanced automation. Once we have told Fillout that we're working with SmartSuite, we don't have to tell it what to do with the data. It already knows. It's talking to SmartSuite directly through the integration. And this is one of those things that makes this such a compelling form software. Okay, inside of here, I choose the theme that I want. You can always edit this later. I'm going to go ahead and pick the plain theme here and move on to the next step. Now, we have to set up our SmartSuite connection. If you don't already have a SmartSuite connection, go ahead and set it up from scratch. It's going to ask you for two things. Number one, your API key. Number two, your workspace ID. In order to find your API key, we can go ahead and flip back into SmartSuite, toggle into your account. This assumes that you have admin level inside of your workspace, and you can go ahead and click on down here at API key. If you don't see API key on your list here, it's probably because you don't have admin level permissions. So make sure you get those first inside of your SmartSuite account, otherwise you can't do any of this other stuff. Now the next piece we need is our workspace ID. If you look up into the URL of your SmartSuite account, your workspace ID is going to be right here before solution. So looking at my overall URL, I've got smartsuite.com, and then inside of those two brackets, what I'm looking for there is that short, 7 or 8 characters. That is my workspace ID. Go ahead and copy that and drop that into your fill-out setup. So I've already built this connection myself. Those are the components you will need to get your integration going. Select your integration once you've found it there from the list and move on to the next step. Now to prove that we've properly integrated with SmartSuite, if I click onto my solutions here, I can see all of my different SmartSuite solutions. And so for us, I've created our example solution called Fillout Form Example, and there it is from the dropdown. I can also look at my apps associated with that solution. In our case, I only have one app in that solution, Contact Form Data. Now, I'm gonna create the form. Here's how easy it is to use Fillout. Of course, give your form a name and then continue. On the left-hand side, you see that it's showing me my SmartSuite fields. So if I scroll on down here, these are the fields inside of SmartSuite, and Fillout has already identified them, it's already mapped to them, and just with simple clicks, I can bring them in. I want my first name, I want my last name, I want a link to my email, I want my phone number. These are the components inside of my SmartSuite app, back here, first name, last name, phone number, and email. This is what I want inside of my form, and I just added them that simply. No fuss, no mess, it's pretty straightforward. Also note that I can add a lot more complexity here if I want. I can come in and set up captions. Here's a test caption. And when I add this, you'll notice that a little bit of text is showing up right here. I can add a placeholder, 888-555-1212. There it is, it's getting dropped in right there. I can add a default value. I can add a default country to this phone number. I can make this required. I can opt to go half width with this and resize a few of the elements on my form. You see how simple it is to just reorganize all of this. I can also drill into the different field settings, add logic, show this conditionally, or hide it under certain conditions. Add some advanced logic as well. Hide the country selection. Maybe I don't want people to have to worry about the country, I just want to collect a number. All kinds of more advanced options available here. I've got my minimum length, a validation pattern, an error message if people aren't giving me the information that I require. All kinds of advanced stuff that's not natively available in the SmartSuite forms is available here inside of Fillouts. Well, this is one of the reasons that Fillout forms are just such an epic evolution of forms in no code. All right, once I'm happy with this, it's that simple. I can publish this form and take it out for a spin. In the upper right corner, I smashed on publish, I'm good. I can now open up the actual live version of the form. Do note, of course, that I can also embed this form. I could do a number of different things in terms of sharing it to get access to the data I need. So, here I am as a user, let's imagine. I'm gonna fill out this information for myself, make sure that everything is looking right. Here we go, I'll put in a fake phone number for myself. In fact, my phone number is 888-555-1112. So let's go ahead and submit here. And the nice thing about Fillout, if I flip back into SmartSuite, my data instantly shows up here. We in no way, shape, or form built an integration. You didn't see me add an automation or anything like that. This all happened automatically through that integration. But we're not done yet. Let's imagine now that I need to create a form link so that people can update the information they've already provided me. So we've captured this information, but now I want to say, hey, Gareth, hey, Johnny, if you want to update your information in my system, you can do it through a form as well. And we can do this with Fillout, updating an existing record through a form submission. This is not natively available in SmartSuite, and this is where Fillout is really going to shine. So let's go ahead and pop back into Fillout. Back at my dashboard, I'm going to go back to my home settings here. Here I am, I just created my new SmartSuite form, but let's duplicate this particular form. By duplicating it, I now have my SmartSuite form 1 and then the original my SmartSuite form. Let's drill into my SmartSuite form 1. This form, a second form, is going to now be at the same integration. It looks exactly the same as the previous form, but this one exists to allow people to update their pre-existing submissions. How do we do that? I'm going to flip into integrations right here. When I go to integrations, again, I will select SmartSuite, which you see was already selected, but it's telling me this is currently set up to create a new record, but I want to update a record. And the best part about Fillout is that it's already created that formula for me. It's created a formula that I can just copy right here with a simple click, go back into my SmartSuite account, and I can set up the formula here. Add a new field. I'm going to add the formula field type, and I'm going to go to the advanced editor and paste in that formula that I just copied from Fillout. I can rename this field. This is going to be the update record URL, and I'll add the field. All right, so now we've created a second form with a specific URL for this very record. Notice that this is different for my two records because the record IDs of these records are different. This one's for Johnny, this one's for Gareth. Let's go back into Fillout now on our form and make sure that we publish these changes that we just made to our second form. I'm gonna go ahead and publish here. Boom, we're done. It reminds me one more time, this is the URL so that people can update. So let's flip back now into SmartSuite and copy and paste this. So this URL right here, this is unique for Gareth. This particular record has a unique URL. I can copy it and paste it into another window. Let's go ahead and do so. And once that loads, we're gonna see Gareth's information here. But maybe Gareth made a mistake when he submitted his phone number. It's supposed to be 1512 at the end. Simple adjustment there, submit that data, and we're done. Back now into SmartSuite, and we can look and see that that new number was instantly updated here in the data source. So, how does this help? Well, we have two separate forms. The initial form that's gonna grab that information, the secondary form that's gonna allow people to update information. So we can build an automation now inside of SmartSuite. That says, when a new record comes into existence here, so simply go into automations and say, let's go, new record is created inside of my contact form data so that when somebody submits that first form, a new record comes in, then we trigger an automation. We can send them an email. Send them an email through Gmail or natively through the SmartSuite account here. And of course, we also have access to Outlook email as well. In our case, I'll just say Google Gmail here. I can send email if I set up my account, and I can send it right here from my automation inside of SmartSuite, and I can provide this URL for them. I can share that URL in an email and say, if you ever need to update your information, here's where you can do it. And again, without any other fancy integrations or anything, we have two forms now. The first one creates a new record. The second one allows people to update their existing data that we have on file. This is stuff we couldn't do natively with SmartSuite forms, but it's available inside of Fillout. I know we went pretty fast here. Obviously, there is a lot to cover with Fillout. If you have questions, please drop them below this video and we'll do our best to answer. Of course, like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And in the meantime, keep on building.